गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। गुड
मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड
मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग
सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सम ऑफ द टाइप्स ऑफ असेसमेंट एंड इवैल्यूएशन एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट फॉर्मेटिव, समेटिव, प्लेसमेंट एंड डायग्नोस्टिक। These four types we have already discussed. Today we will discuss about norm reference test and the criterion reference test. What is the norm reference and what is the criterion reference test? These two things we will discuss and in which situation they can be used. What are the situation where you can use a norm reference test? Or in which situation you can use a criterion reference test. These two things we will also see. I hope that you must have some understanding about the norm reference and criterion reference. Do you have some idea about that? Anybody can reply?
Yes, sir.
Yes. What are those?
Sir, norm reference. Sir, norm reference test हम लोग use करते हैं to compare the students' performance with others. Mainly used to discriminate between high and low achiever, whereas criteria reference test is used to compare the students' performance to a fixed or specific on the basis of fixed or specific criteria.
What will be those criteria? What kind of a fixed criteria?
जैसे कि हम लोग जानना चाहते हैं कितना स्किल वो अचीव कर रहा है, whether the students have achieved specific skills or whether he has content mastery.
So, how you will decide those mastery level or the skill or better to say that the criteria? Anybody else? They can also reply.
Okay, sir.
Damodar, are you getting me?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Are you outside? At home?
Sir, I'm at home only, sir.
So? Why this so much background noise is coming? It seems that you are traveling.
No sir, that fan sound I think.
Okay, okay. So how those criteria will be determined? Can you say that?
No sir.
Okay. संतोष जी, संतोष आर यू हियर? संतोष ओके। शालिनी, कैन यू से दैट व्हाट आर नॉर्म रेफरेंस टेस्ट एंड क्राइटेरियन रेफरेंस टेस्ट, बिकॉज दिस इज नॉट अ वेरी न्यू थिंग्स।
नो सर, एक्चुअली याद नहीं आ रहा है।
ओके।
सी सर, मैं ट्राई करता हूँ।
हाँ, प्लीज
सर। ये जो नॉर्म रेफरेंस और क्राइटेरिया रेफरेंस, तो हम जो ये जो नेट एग्जाम दे रहे हैं, तो मैं नेट एग्जाम से कंपेयर करता हूँ। एक क्राइटेरिया रेफरेंस है और एक नॉर्म रेफरेंस है। तो ये जो नॉर्म रेफरेंस में आएगा, जो स्टूडेंट परफॉर्मेंस जितके आसी तांकर माने गोटे परसेंटेज रैंक से आसीबो, बट इन क्राइटेरिया रेफरेंस रे, बट इन क्राइटेरिया रेफरेंस रेफरेंस में जैसे रहता है 6%, वो जो जेआरएफ के लिए 6% जो क्राइटेरिया रहता है वो आएगा शायद क्राइटेरिया रेफरेंस में, मतलब ये बेंचमार्क।
यू हैव स्टार्टेड वेल तनुज, बट बीच में थोड़ा सा प्रॉब्लम हो गया. यू स्टार्टेड वेल. ठीक है. इफ यू कुड हैव टोल्ड ओनली अप टू द नॉर्म रेफरेंस टेस्ट, इट कुड हैव बीन बेटर. ओके. एनीवे, सो yesterday the type of assessment and evaluation that we have seen, that was based upon the purpose. Okay, what is the purpose of conducting test? Okay, here the type of assessment and evaluation that we will be seeing, it will be based upon the reference. What is your point of reference? And that's why we used to say that the norm reference test and the criterion reference test. Okay, so here the main point of distinction, division, is the reference, point of reference. Suppose that you take one example wherein you are conducting a test, and based upon the participant in the test, and suppose that in a class you are conducting a test, in the class there are 50 students, and based upon the score that you have got out of conducting the test, based upon the score you are categorizing the student, you are labeling the student that some students are high performer, some students are the moderate performer or the average performer, and some students are the low performer student. Here what we are doing, here we are comparing the score secured by the individual student with the group of a student within that group, with the student of that class. Out of 50 students, 10 students have secured high mark maximum. So I am saying that they are the highest performer. Or better to say another example, when I say that this student X is the topper of his class, I am not considering the score of other student. I am considering only the score of that class only, and I am saying that this boy X have secured the maximum mark in his class, that's why he is a topper. But he may not be a topper when we consider the score of the child outside the group. For sake of example, you are a student of a AMID class, and some student have secured out of 500, 400 mark, which is the highest mark in this class. So you can term that child as the topper of the class, or the highest scorer student of the class. But some other student from some other institute in the same course may have secured 450 mark. So see, the child, the student who is the highest scorer, topper of the class, will no more topper when they will be compared to the other group of a student. The point of saying is, when we compare the marks secured by the student in his or her group only, their group only, then it is treated as the norm reference test, where the norm is the group. When it comes the example of a class, then the norm is the class. Because here I am comparing means I am interpreting. When I am saying that the particular student is the topper or the highest scorer, what I am doing? I am interpreting the score secured by that particular child, a score of that particular child. So in this situation, the type of interpretation that we have, the type of a comparison that we have is a norm reference test. And that's why in general, usually we use to compare the performance of a child within that group. That's why it is known as the conventional method of assessment, because we used to do in our day-to-day practices. Somewhere it is written as a traditional method of assessment and evaluation. However, personally, I don't prefer to use the traditional word. Okay, so this type of a testing when we will do, it is the norm referent test. For example, you can take that all the class test or the public examination test, like that Tanuj was saying, the NET examination. NET examination is a norm reference test where your score is compared with the other candidate who are appearing in the NET examination. And based upon the performance of the whole group, it is decided that who will be qualified for NET. And that's why the cutoff mark vary every time, because the every time performance of the student may not be same or a similar. Suppose that in the NET examination conducted in the June, performance of the students are very high, so the cutoff mark will go high. If in the coming December examination, the performance of the candidates are low, so the cutoff mark will go low. This is the norm reference test examination. Even for the entrance purpose, even for the employment purpose, whatever the testing that we used to do, these are the norm reference test. Because suppose that for any recruitment examination or for any entrance examination that you have faced before enrolling to this course, 1000 students have appeared. So your score will be compared to those 1000 students only, and those who will be on the top of the rank we will select for the admission. Like that, here we have a 50 seat. So the top 50 scorer will get chance for the admission. And of course, we will consider the reservation criteria and all those things. So reservation criteria within that also. Suppose that there is a list of OBC students. So, and within the OBC, suppose that the 20 seat is there. So 20 top scorer will get a chance. Here I am not comparing the performance of the candidate with the other group. I am only comparing the performance of the candidate to that particular group. And that's why that group is known as the norm group. And with reference to the group, if we are interpreting the result, then this is known as the norm reference assessment or evaluation, isn't it? And here the individual score is measured from the score of the other group members. That is the one thing. But you can think of that it may not be always very much desirable. Why it may not be always very much desirable? Because if I am taking an examination of MED class and the maximum score is 30 out of 50, and a child who have scored 30, I can say that this is the top scorer, highest ranker in the examination. However, the child may not have all the required competency, skill, knowledge, understanding, which is required for the course, which we know as a learning outcome. And when we write the course, design a course, even when we design a lesson plan, then we decide a learning objective. Means a course is intended to inculcate those qualities, those value, those skills, those knowledge among the learner. In order to qualify certain course, you must have a required level of a competency. So what is required, that when I am saying that the person is qualified in that particular course, then I must see the qualification with reference to the objective of the course, with reference to the objective of the lesson. And I must search for the learning outcome with respect to the learning objective of the course. For sake of example, a student passing out the board examination, or a class 8 examination, or 9 examination, whatever, we must see that the student have a required level of a competency, knowledge, skill, as per the learning objective of the course. If the child fails to have a required level of a competency, even though the child is the highest scorer of his class, will not have a significant impact. So the criterion reference test says that instead of interpreting the result with the score of other student in that group, the score must be interpreted, the result must be interpreted with reference to the objective of the course, with reference to the learning outcome of the course. That should be the point of a reference for interpretation and analysis of the marks secured. Comparing within the group will not serve the purpose, because I know the child have a required level of competency and skill or not. Problem solving skill, demonstration skill, reading skill, writing skill, communication skill, these are there or not. And with reference to that, I can decide the performance of the child in the test. And that's why when we talk about the criterion reference test, actually the concept of criterion reference test comes in the educational scenario when the concept of writing and developing learning outcome came. Before that, the concept of a criterion reference test was not there, because here the criteria is the objective of the course. So if the objective of the course is not there, obviously the criterion reference test will not be there. So objective of the course will come in the educational practices, then we have started thinking about the criterion reference test. And when you will see the criterion reference test, it is an attempt to interpret the result in terms of clearly defined learning outcome of the course or the test. Clearly defined learning outcome here we consider. Whereas in the norm reference test, we are not considering any learning outcome. We were only considering a group, and we are saying that that particular child is the topper, highest performer, and this particular child is the low performer, or some particular group of a child is a moderate performer, average performer. But here the point is, we have to see the performance of the child with reference to the learning outcome, with reference to the objective of the course, with reference to the objective of the lesson, whatever the case is applicable in that. So this is the main concept about the norm reference testing and the criterion reference testing. Now come to the point that why it is required to have a criterion reference test. What was the difficulty when we were doing the norm reference testing? And still the norm reference testing are used widely. Suppose that you have given the example of a NET examination. We used to use the norm reference testing. Okay. Or in the some cases, a combination of norm reference and a criterion reference test can also be used. But first, in order to understand, we will see that what are the situations where we can use a norm reference, or where we can use a criterion reference, or we can use a mixed of both. See, in the first case, if your objective is to see that who are the highest performer student, or a group of a student who is highest performer in the test. So in that case, we can use a norm reference test, because I am only concerned about knowing the highest performer. I am not concerned about that whether you have all competencies, skill, understanding, or a knowledge or not. Suppose that in any course, there may be a set of knowledge required, a set of competency required, set of skill required, set of understanding of the concept required. That must be. So, in that case, if only you are interested to know the performance, we will use the norm reference. But if you are interested to know that what is the level of achievement of a student with reference to the preset well-defined criteria, well-defined objectives, well-defined learning outcome, then we have to use a criterion reference. For sake of example, in the B.Ed. examination, one set of a criteria may be your communication skill. Because as a teacher, we must be a very good communicator. Another set of criteria may be your skill of handling ICT tools for teaching learning. That must be one criteria. Or other thing may be that your understanding about the different learning theory. That must be one criteria. And when we see the B.Ed. examination, actually it is a combination of all that for assessing the communication skill, teaching skill, ICT skill. We have an internship program which is evaluated and assessed also. For content level mastery, we have a paper pencil written test also, isn't it? So if we are assessing all those things, which is the well-defined learning outcome, then it will become a criteria. So I was talking that where we can use a norm reference and where we can use a criterion reference. But in some cases, you must or you may be required the blend of both. Like that, you may be required to have a criteria with respect to the predefined, well-defined learning outcome. And you also want to compare the performance of a student within the group. So in that case, we can use the combination of norm referencing and criterion referencing test. For sake of example, you want to recruit someone for some post. So for that, through the testing, you may be interested to know that the person or a candidate have a required level of a competency or not, which is required for the post. So what you will do, you will set out some criteria that these things should be there, and you will design a test. And before qualifying someone suitable for the post, you will first check that who are the candidate who have a required level of a competency, a skill, knowledge and understanding as per the predefined criteria for the post, and you will shortlist them. And after shortlisting them, you will compare the performance of the shortlisted candidate within the group, and those who are the highest performer among the group, in the group, you will select them for the post. So it is a blend of the criterion reference and the norm referencing testing. And when we talk about the different initiatives of the government in the education system, you must have heard of the MLL, minimum level of learning, or the mastery lag. Okay, these two concepts are based on the criterion reference test. When we say that the minimum level of learning means a student passing out from one grade to another grade must have this set of a competency, skill, knowledge and understanding. Here it doesn't matter much that what is the position of a child in that group. Irrespective of the position, we must see the level of a competency that the MLL talks, minimum level of learning. Even now you must have heard of, and in the several time in the class I have discussed, that NCERT has come up with the learning outcome at elementary stage, learning outcome at a secondary level, the MLL, minimum level of learning. It is philosophy based upon the criterion reference test. And I was talking about that NCERT has come up with a learning outcome at elementary level, learning outcome at a secondary level, and learning outcome at a senior secondary level is in the developmental phase. When we say these things, learning outcome, it suggests that the testing, evaluation and assessment should be the criterion based. because here we have to see the minimum level of learning outcome which is achieved by the children or not. So that is the case of criterion reference testing. Okay. And when we talk about the difference between these two type of a testing, that is the norm reference testing and a criterion reference testing, actually the difference is on the basis of interpretation. How do you interpret and design the test? If you are designing and interpreting a test for comparing the score within the group, it will become a norm reference. If you are designing and interpreting with reference to the learning outcome, learning objective, then it will become a criterion reference.